Hey guys, so guys, in this video series, we are going to start with linked list. We'll understand what a linked list is, and then we are working with stacks and queues. We'll learn how to use stacks and queues with R implementation, with linked list implementation. So let's begin with our first topic, that what is a linked list.
Please do not forget to subscribe to this channel and click on the bell icon to receive all the latest updates.
So I'll start with why we needed a linked list. So suppose you have an array. Okay, it has maybe 5 locations and this is an integer array. All right, it currently has values -8, 2, 11, 3, and 99. So what if I want to insert one more value into this array? So arrays are fixed length. Okay, I cannot append one more location to this array, right? So if I want to maybe add one more value at the end of the array, which is say 100, okay, I'll have to create another array, okay, with size 5 plus 1. So I'll have to create one more array, okay, with size 5 plus 1, and copy all the values which are originally in these 5 locations and then place in the 6th value. So the operation of inserting one more value in this current array is an on operation. Okay, this is also an integer array. Okay, that is, I have to copy this entire array into this new array. It runs n times, so it is on operation. So appending value to the end of the array is one of those problems solved by linked list where the operation is constant, right? So this same thing is on in linked list. Okay, so what if you want to remove the first value from this array, right? You want to get rid of -8, okay? So what you'll do is you'll create an array of 5 locations because one value you have removed, okay? And we'll copy all the remaining values into this new array, okay? And this operation again is on because you are running through the entire length of the array, okay? So this is also another problem which is solved by linked list where you have to remove the first value. When you remove the first value in array, it is an on operation. And even if you don't create a new array, right, you have to shift all these values here to left 1. So then too, in that case also, you'll have to iterate through the entire array. The complexity in that case is also on. So in either case that you shift the elements or you create a new array, the complexity is on, which is constant for linked list. So comparing arrays and linked list further, so suppose if you want to maybe insert a value between 3 and 99, or maybe get rid of 3, that is a middle value in the list. So in that case, linked list and arrays have the same complexity. Okay, appending a last value and removing the first value is constant in linked list, but is on in arrays. Now let's see how a linked list actually works behind the scenes. Suppose we have a class called node, okay? It's just a class. A class can have data members and methods. It has a data member int I, and it also has a data member of the same type of this class, and it is called next. So this is a class with two data members. One is to store an integer, the other is to store the reference of type node. So when you create a node and you write node n1 is equals to new node, okay, and you say n1 dot I is equals to 10. Let's understand what's happening here. So this is the call to the default constructor. We'll cover this when we cover constructors. We are creating an object of node. The name of the object is n1, and we are setting the value I in n1 to 10. This is equivalent to saying that in the memory, I'm creating a space enough to store an I and a type of reference next, okay, and the name of this location is n1. So n1 of I of n1 has 10, and the next of n1 is set to null. So this will point to null. So what I'm trying to say is, when you create an object, a memory is provided with this particular name. So variables can also be thought as name memory locations. So you can think this memory location with the name n1 that can store an integer, has current value 10, and can store a reference of the same type node which is currently storing none. So this is what this statement actually means behind the scenes. Now, how does it work out into a linked list of nodes? So if you take another node, node n2 is equals to new node, okay, you say n2.i is equals to 20. So the same thing happens here. You get another location, okay, the name of this location is n2. It can store a value of type integer, which is I, stores currently 10, and can store a reference of type node, and it is set to null. Now, how do we get a linked list out of nodes? So this location is possible of storing the address where a type of node is stored, right? So this can point to n1 and this can point to n2. So what we do, rather than keeping it null, we make it point to n2. How do we do that? In the code, we say n1.next is equals to n2. So you get n2 as the next of n1, right? So this is how you connect nodes. Just giving you a quick revision. So n1 is basically the name of this memory location that is capable of storing one integer and an address of type n1. So for the integer, it is stored in 10 because we set I of n1 to 10. And for the next location, it is pointing to n2 because it can store the address of an object which is of type node. So currently, it is pointing to n2, which we set here. Initially, it was set to null. Now, I take another node. Node n3 is equals to new node. I set n3.i is equals to 30 and n3.next is equals to null. Same thing happens. I get a name memory location. The name of this memory location is n3. Alright. It gets the space, the memory to store an integer, which is I, and the value set to 30. It also gets the memory to store the reference of type node, which is variable next here, and it is set to null. We'll do the same thing to link n2 to n3. I'll say n2.next is n3. The next of n2 becomes, because this is a memory location capable of holding an address of type object node. So this is, you see, we are getting a link of nodes, which is called a linked list essentially. So this is the idea behind how a linked list works. You have a node and nodes are connected to each other via a link. For a doubly linked list, there is a connection to the previous node as well. For example, from n1, I can use next to go to the next node. Similarly, in doubly linked list, from n2, I can use another variable previous to go to the previous node. So in that case, we would have something like this here as well, node previous. But we are starting with singly linked list, so we'll just not use it for now. So this is what is basically a linked list, and this concept remains the same in C++, Java, C, C Sharp, Python, everywhere. It's just that how you store references differs. For example, in Java, you just have object references. In C, you have pointers. In C, C++, you have object references and pointers as well.
So this is just the code that we wrote, and we had a class node. It has an integer I and a reference to node next, and we created three nodes, and this is what I've created here, three nodes, and I've linked them the same way. The next of n1 is n2, the next of n2 is n3. So you start with an empty list, and then you have n1 as the first node, then n1, n2, then n1, n2, n3, and I'm printing the value of n1 at n2 and n3, and the next of n1, which is essentially n2, and the next of n2, and the next of n1. So let's see what we get. N1 is 10, which is this value at n1's next is 20, which is n2. Okay, because we linked n2 to n1's next. Similarly, value of n3 is 30, and the next of n2 is 30 because n2's next is n3. And similarly, n2 is next of n1, so n1's next is n3, which is 30. Okay, so I hope this was helpful. So in the coming videos, we'll discuss how to insert values in a linked list, how to delete values in a linked list, and how to implement them in the code.